Hey guys, this is Mr. PMJ, and today I want to talk about the top 10 things I don't like about this car. Although it's pretty hard to dislike anything in this car, but I'm gonna try and come up with a few anyway. So the first thing is, when I went to the dry cleaners and then I had to bring my shirt back to the car, and I was looking for a coat rack, and this car doesn't have a coat rack. So I had to make do. And I'm using the sun visor as a coat rack. So that's the first thing. And then the other things that I've mentioned in my other videos that I've solved are the belt guide here. It tends to come loose. So to solve that, I got some tube shrink wrap. Shrink tubes, I'm sorry. And that's how I solved it. And the next thing is the infamous cup holders that are too shallow. Well, to solve that, you buy a bunch of these foam cup holders. Keeps your drinks cold and hot longer, and it fills in the space. Okay, and the next thing I'd like to talk about is the heat. This is a big 6.2 liter engine, and it's right at my leg, so I can feel the heat coming through around this area and also around this area. And to solve that problem, I just have the air conditioning diverted to both my face and my feet below. But on long trips, the other area that heats up is behind the seat. This area, this cargo area above there. And usually you don't notice it, but on a long trip, and if you're covering that area up, then there's no place for the heat to dissipate to. And that's where the exhaust tubes are coming across, and it's just below the cargo floor. And that's why it gets so hot. And plus you have the transaxle back there. So to continue my list of dislikes, these things are, in case the battery dies, well, the instruction manual says you have to go through your trunk with your physical key and pull a latch there, which will open the front door. Yes, that is a possibility, but that's not a great design, because in the Aston Martin, their design is within this little keyhole area, this handle area, there'd be a little keyhole that you can just stick your physical key in here to open up the door. And that makes a lot more sense to me than having to go through the trunk. The other thing is that the rev match is an awesome feature, because it makes the shift transitions a lot smoother for the passenger, but at the same time it reduces wear on my clutch. The problem is that every time you start up the car again, by default it's off, so you have to manually turn it on. And the other thing is that because the car panels are not steel at all, I once took it on a long trip and I got caught in a hailstorm. And because it's not steel, it's all carbon fiber or composite materials, it is really loud when the hail hits it. Although the benefit is you're not gonna get dents like steel. So I guess that's all, and hope you have a great day. Bye. The other thing I don't like about this car is that it doesn't have mirrors on the... I mean, the mirrors don't have turn signals on them. Either on the outside, an LED light, or inside the mirror itself to indicate that you're changing lanes. Now, the European version, export version, has it, but the US version doesn't. So, in the future, that's something I'm probably gonna add. And I guess that's it. Have a great day. Another thing I dislike is that these side marker lights, when they light up, it's really just two LEDs at the top where my index, my middle finger, are pointing to, because you're expecting the whole length of the side marker to turn on, but they don't. However, there is an aftermarket company named Oracle that makes them, and it looks like it's a pretty easy pop out the old ones and pop in the new ones. So that's something I'll probably do in the future also. And another thing is that I love the seventh gear, because on the freeway I could be cruising 80 miles and it's only revving 1500 RPM. But you tend to accidentally go into seventh gear if you're not paying attention and you want it to go into fifth gear. To solve that, anytime I want to go fifth gear, I just aim for the upper right hand corner of the center display. But there's already a solution for that. With Porsche, they have a lockout that prevents you from going into seventh if you're going from any other numbers other than six. So that's a design that hopefully Chevrolet will incorporate in the future. So because this car is a sports car, it's pretty low to the ground. The red body panel starts at 6 inches off the ground, and then the air dam below it, you only have about 3 inches around there. And there's been a couple of times I got really close to the curb in front of me, and I almost hit my red bumper. So I wish there were some kind of audio beep indicator to let me know that I'm about to hit the curb. And I wish it came with that. The good thing is that the aftermarket does have a product out there called Curb Alert. So I bought it and it's on its way. In an upcoming future video, I'll show you the installation and the end result. And it's probably even more important for those who get the splitters, because that makes your body even lower than the red bumper where you see me. Mine is at. So another thing I don't like is the steering wheel trim piece at the bottom here. It's left unfinished because Chevrolet and aftermarket sell pieces that you can adhere to that, and they can be either painted to match the car body, or they can be made out of carbon fiber in a matte finish or a high gloss finish. So for me, I ordered a real carbon fiber high gloss, and it's an aftermarket and it's coming. I wanted high gloss because I like Ferraris, and their steering wheel has the high gloss finish and it looks really good. So that's the look I'm going for. Thanks, have a good day.